The details of happiness vary from person to person. But the process of happiness is always the same. You could be happy upon looking at one type of food. Somebody else could be happy looking at another type of food. So the details may vary, but the process is the same. The process is the same. What is happiness? Who will explain in terms of what we have discussed so far? Already, in fact, we have already taken this up, but whatsoever. Who will explain what is happiness? Yes. Yes. What is happiness?
Opposite of happiness.
Right. How does it arise?
We feel happiness when we have been in a state when we are not happy. So we compare it with the past.
Appreciate this. The default state of the brain is sadness. The bulk of the human population is always, by default, in a state of boredom, frustration, anxiety, irritation, and the like, which are all nothing but sadness. Are you getting it? It is man's lot to live in sadness, given the way the brain is. And why is the brain always sad? Because it has nothing of its own. Remember we said, all that it has come from? And what has come from outside can be sad. So it is always insecure. All sadness is nothing but that insecurity. That's the default state of brain, to always be insecure, to always be sad. And because it is always sad, hence it is always looking for happiness, obviously. Right? It does not know real happiness. The brain can never know real happiness. So it is looking for some kind of a cheap substitute. It is looking for some kind of a cheap substitute, which it finds in various objects. Position, power, performance, money, appreciation, prestige, reputation, all these things, right? The brain does not know the real thing. What is the real thing? Joy. The joy of intelligence. The brain cannot know that. But it is always insecure, so it is looking for some kind of medicine. Happiness is that medicine. But it is a false medicine. Happiness is a false medicine. Are you getting it? A substitute, a cheap, unworthy substitute for joy. The joy the brain cannot reach. So it says, fine, let me have marks. I cannot get joy, but at least get me some marks. At least get me some acceptability. Or let me get a girlfriend. Something which can become a cheap substitute to real joy. And because it is cheap, hence it never succeeds. Hence, happiness is always followed by a lack of happiness. Your happiness always comes as an excitement, it subsides, right? It's never permanent. Comes and then subsides and goes away. And this lack of happiness is called as then sadness, right? Happiness and sadness always following each other, a dualistic process, right? Clear?